Very good morning once again to all the students. After 4 days, we are going to continue the chapter again. So I have to give you brief gist once again. Clear? Let's have a look on the board first. Am I audible to all online children? Keep on sending their feedback. So we have characters of Albert Einstein at school. Our protagonist is Albert Einstein himself. Then Mr. Braun is the history teacher. Elsa is the cousin of Albert. And then Yuri is his best friend, you can say, right? And then this chapter will be, you can say, showing the real concept of education system. Everybody has different concept, right? The system where Albert was studying, that was quite rigid. The kind of schooling he got, where facts were given more importance rather than practical learning. So he was the kind of boy who believed in ideas and creativity. When he never thought that mugging up the information, it's like cramming and puking out in the exam. One should do with understanding according to Albert Einstein. So he could not fit himself into the education system at that time when he was studying. Fine. And then teacher-taught relation. So another theme, very important theme, is the kind of relation teacher-taught means student here. Fine. So teacher-student relationship. That what sort of relationship a teacher and student should have? You tell me. It should be very rigid or conservative, or it should be open and friendly. First or second? Second. Fine. So why? Because teacher and the student should have the relation in which students can, you know, express themselves freely, or they can put forth their problems, or they are facing this problem either in their, you can say, life or in the education, or they are not able to understand, only then they will be able to tell, okay, we are not able to understand this, and then they can solve the problem. But he was studying in the system where Mr. Braun, history teacher, asked him a question that where did that Battle of Waterloo, when did that take place? So rather than mugging up the information when and what, Albert was saying that I believe that I should know why. Why that happened, why that battle was fought, okay? Yes, but please pay attention here. That why was battle fought rather than when? So he was interested in that. So most of the students are joined today. I guess all are present in class, offline as well as online. That's good. Then problems faced by students at this age. So this is, these are the basic themes and these are the characters. So what we have read so far? Yes, Divnu, tell me. In the beginning, when chapter started, Mr. Braun, history teacher, asked a question, and there was a kind of argument between the teacher and Albert Einstein. He says that he does not know the answer because he does not believe in cramming the facts. So then teacher says, asked him for what? See, in fact, of 4 days. Anybody remember? Yes, Sahaj? Raman?
He says that he doesn't see any point in remembering.
Yes, he says that he doesn't see any point. Very good. Yes, so. Yes, online children, you can also participate. If you want to speak, you can raise your hand. Better way. So, here, chapter starts with when teacher asks a question and Einstein was not able to give answer, and then both of them start a kind of argument started. So he says, okay, I do not believe in cramming the facts. Then he asked, what is Einstein's ideas of education? Then rather than keeping mum, he stood up and he started telling the whole class that the idea of education which belonged to him, that ideas, imagination, that is real education rather than cramming. So teacher became quite annoyed at this, and what did teacher say? Yes, Aditi, do you remember what punishment was given by the teacher? See, it means you're not at all able to concentrate. Yes, that is so easy, that he should attend an extra class, extra period that day. That was the punishment only. There was no slapping and all that. Fine. So do not guess, just read. Sit down. Please go and read the chapter again. So teacher gave the punishment that he should attend an extra lecture. So let's start. Then after that, his cousin Elsa she will be coming. And Yuri and Albert, they are best friends. They share a very good bond. They talk about. Now, at school, I told you that he's not at all satisfied. Now, let's talk about Albert's residence. He's living at lodgings, Durani ka uska jagah hai, at a rented room, where the landlady, owner of the house, that she's very annoying, very, you can say, noisy. She keeps on beating her children. And all time there is a lot of noise and cries and shouting, and Albert is not able to concentrate on his studies. Whenever he tries to play violin, he is fond of playing violin as his hobby. So she does not like that also. She compares the music of violin with the wailing, W-A-I-L-I-N-G. Wailing means Rona. She says that stop playing this. So he is not able to concentrate on his studies. He cannot play his musical instrument. And one more thing, she herself is being beaten up every Saturday by her husband. That landlady is being beaten up by her husband on every weekend. And so that's why she is frustrated, and the kind of treatment she is giving to her children is the same. So that is another story, but it is affecting Albert a lot. Albert shares this thing with Yuri also. So Yuri says, you are far better than me. The lodgings where I reside, where murderers are living. After murdering, they want to get scar on their face so that they can wear it in a very good way, or to show to others that yes, we have murdered someone. And they are not behind the bars even. So he tells that this is the place where I live, you are much better. Yeah. Then Elsa also visits Albert Einstein, and he says it is very difficult for me to cram. And Elsa gives suggestions of cramming to him, that it is very easy, just like a parrot. And you have to mug up some information and you have to write in the exam. So Albert says, this is the problem. I cannot cram at all. And then one book he used to carry with him, that what the subject it was? Geology. Fine, study of rocks and related things, areas and geography. So he was interested in that, sciences and maths specifically. So he kept on reading books outside his syllabus also. So now we are on page 29. I'll be sharing the screen with you all, if possible. Let's see. So let it be, you have the books, beta. Yes, send me your feedback. All online children, you're having the books, okay? The folder is not saved anyhow. Okay, fine. Then it's okay, you can open page number 29. Kindly open page 29. Have you read it? So yes, we have read about Dr. Wheel also. The next character, Dr. Wheel. Now, problems faced by students in this chapter, problems, psychological problems. They get nervous during exams or in the relationship with the teacher and taught. In this, what happens when Albert was getting bad treatment in the school, he was not able to, you know, get along with the system. He started facing nervous breakdown. He thought to that extent, he thought that I should, you know, go to a doctor. I should get a fake medical certificate that I have nervous breakdown issue. And that way I will be getting months leave and I will go back to Milan, where my parents reside in Paris. Milan is fine there. So he says that I'll be going there. And that will be the only way. My parents will get annoyed if I go back without getting any fake certificate. So that was the decision. And Yuri helped him out. He searched for a doctor and they could not get experienced doctor. Obviously, nobody is going to write fake certificate and all. So they decided to, a newly passed out doctor was there who just completed his studies and became a doctor. So they talked to Dr. Wheel. Dr. Ernst Wheel is his full name, E-R-N-E-S-T. And he is the one who's very smart, though he has completed his studies recently, does not have experience, but is very smart perceiver, very smart observer. He observes that Albert Einstein is definitely having the problem of nervous breakdown. And he does not know about it. Because he has 11th and soch liya that I will be, you know, faking it, I will be getting removed and all, I'll be going from this place. So he's so nervous. Then we are going to read about the conversation between the two. Here, page 29. I don't really know how to describe my trouble, Dr. Wheel, he began. Don't try, said the young doctor with a friendly smile. Yuri has already given me a history of the case. Oh, what did he say? Only that you want me to think you have had a nervous breakdown and say that you must not go back to school.
We have not won the mic today, I forgot. Now is it clear? Even then you are able to listen to me without mic also. Online children, I'm asking you. Manjot, Arshpreet, Raghav, am I audible? No response means you're not there. So only that you want me to think you have had a nervous breakdown. So Yuri has already informed Dr. Wheel that my friend is going to come to you. This is his case history. And then you can talk to him. And doctor says, I already know about you, Albert. Albert was so disheartened that already my friend has told everything to the doctor. That is quite embarrassing that I'm going to get fake certificate. What will the doctor say? He will not give me certificate now. Why not? Isn't it true then? Yes, that's the trouble. Now you will say there is nothing wrong with me. You will tell me to go back to school. So Einstein got disheartened after knowing that Yuri has already informed the doctor about my condition. That fake certificate wala jo scene tha. But he says, don't be too sure of that, said the doctor. As a matter of fact, I'm pretty sure you are in a nervous state about that school. Underline this. So doctor was smart enough. He was able to perceive that you are definitely having this problem. It is not that you're going to fake it. You are too nervous that you went to that extent of thinking of a plan of leaving the school. It is a sign of nervous breakdown only, that you cannot stand in front of those systems and school, and you're too nervous to go there. Then, but I have not told you anything about it, said Albert. Albert thought that if a problem is there, na, we should tell the doctor that, sir, I have this problem, you treat it. But here, diagnosis is already done by the doctor. Jo psychological problems hoti hai, beta, we have n number of psychological problems. Many a times, more than 50% people do not know that they are facing a mental problem. They will not agree to it. You have seen some people, they keep on checking one thing 10 times. In your elderly people, you might have seen that. They think that ki ye na ho jaye. There are people who have, they are obsessed with cleanliness. Everything should be spick and span. OCD bol dete hain syndrome ko. Fine? That everything should be clean. That is also a kind of, you can say, related to mental health only. Then there are n number of mental illnesses and problems people are suffering and they do not know actually. Fine? And they think that I need not go to doctor. But there are, in the poster it is written 5 out of 10 people are suffering with mental health illnesses. Clear? So it does not mean the person is mad. The thing is, a person is facing the problem, it does not know. And sometimes people feel like crying all the time. Without any reason you cry. Going through the depression. The other person has not said anything to you, but you start crying. So there are many problems. So he does not know that he is going through nervous breakdown. He thought of a plan of getting that certificate of leaving the school. And doctor says, you are having this problem. He says, doctor, I don't tell you. How can you say that? Wide-eyed. Albert was so shocked. He was wondering how doctor is saying, how can you know that, doctor? Because you would not have come to see me about this if you had not been pretty close to a nervous breakdown. That's why. So doctor gives the explanation that already you are quite close. He was not having the problem, but he is on the verge of it. If he will be staying here in the school in the same system, facing same problem, definitely he is going to have this problem. So doctor was smart enough. Doctor said briskly, if I certify that you have had a nervous breakdown and must stay away from school for a while, what will you do? So doctor says, okay, I will give you the certificate. You go. Tell me, what will you do next? Tell me your plan. I'll go to Italy, said Albert, to Milan, where my parents are. And what will you do there? I will try to get into an Italian college or institute. Doctor says, how can you do it without a diploma? You cannot get admission into other college without getting certificate from the previous one. I'll ask my mathematics teacher to give me something about my work, and perhaps that will be enough. I have learned all the maths they teach at school and a bit more, he added when Dr. V looked doubtful. Doctor was very good. He was able to think that this boy is certainly going through this problem. I should write a certificate for him. But the problem is, if I write and if he goes, it can be blot to his career. How will he get admission? Doctor was concerned. So he says, I have a plan that I can get reference from. You know that reference letters? When you go abroad also, many children come to school. They get reference letters from their teachers, class teachers specifically, principal and the people who have the authority to give. So in that we have to mention that this child has good background and has cleared and all. If reference is there, you can get admission. So he was knowing this, that even if institute does not give me any reference letter, this system is very famous or popular in foreign countries. If a teacher gives you a reference letter, you can get admission if you want to switch to another institute, fine. So he says, I will get written letter from my maths teacher, because uski maths teacher ke saath hi banti thi. You know, you can perceive that sometimes we like a teacher, sometimes we like the subject, sometimes we do not like the subject but we like the teacher, sometimes both. So it happens in the school system. Fine, a teacher gets annoyed with you, says main aapko daantti hu jaise aise plates bana ke aana, you should do this, you start hating me. Okay, teacher is points on me only. You do not see the point ki why, rather than fine, acha aapne ye kaam nahi kiya, stand up and go out of the class. You get punishment in junior classes, I'm saying. So in that way, every teacher taught relation is different, fine. So he was having very good relation with maths teacher. He was not having good relation with Mr. Braun, history teacher. So he says, I will take my reference letter from maths teacher. Well, it's up to you, doctor says. I doubt if it will come off, but I can see you are not doing yourself or anyone else much good by staying here. How long would you like me to say you should stay away from school? Would 6 months be all right? So doctor says, okay, that is up to you then. If you have planned something, how long you want that leave? How long should I write that you need rest to stay away from school? Would 6 months be all right? He says, this is very kind of you. Yes, please listen to the data. How many months? Yes. 6 months. Please listen. So this is very kind of you, he says. It's nothing. I have only just stopped being a student myself, so I know how you feel. So he says that just I completed my studies. I have entered from student to a doctor. I am now. So I can feel you, what you are going through. Here you are. I have just stopped being a student myself. So Dr. Veal handed him the certificate and best of luck. So doctor was kind enough to understand the condition of his mind and gave him the certificate. How much? Nothing. If you have anything to spare, invite Yuri to a meal. Fine. He says, how much, sir, I have to pay you? Doctor ko pooch raha hai. Doctor says, Dr. Veal says, no, nothing. If anything you want to give, you can invite your friend Yuri to a dinner or meal only. He's a good friend of mine and yours too, I think. So doctor did not ask for any money. Albert had no money to spare, but he pretended he had and took Yuri out to supper. Aise friends ke saath hota hai. So he asked Yuri, okay, let's have dinner. Supper means dinner. And Albert was not having money in his pocket, but he's taking him out. So page number 30, beta. Isn't it wonderful? He said after showing Yuri the certificate. Yes, it's fine, Yuri agreed. 6 months is a good period. This way you won't actually be leaving the school. So if the worst comes to the worst, you will be able to come back and carry on for your diploma. So Yuri says, okay, 6 months ka leave mil gaya tere ko, school leaving certificate jisko keh dete hain. For not school leaving certificate exactly, it was a kind of medical leave, you can say, in our terms. Because doctor has signed it that he's going through nervous breakdown. He needs 6 months break. Fine. So he says you can go for your diploma. If anything happens over there, you're not able to continue. Something happens, you can come back and continue your diploma here also. Albert says, no, I will never go back to that place. Albert assured him, I'm going to take this certificate to the head teacher tomorrow, and that will be the end of it. So that was the plan. Bahut dhyan se suna bhi hona ke hai. We think something else happens, something else. So he thought, this certificate of doctor, I will be showing to the head of the school, and that is my last day, and I will not enter into this institution. Don't forget to get a reference in writing from your mathematics teacher, Yuri reminded him. So Yuri says, okay, if you are going for the last day, definitely take the reference letter from your math teacher. Mr. Coach willingly gave Albert the reference he wanted. Underline, next character, beta. Mr. Coach is the math teacher, you should know the name. He was very kind, and he was the one who could see that Albert is having that vision, intelligence. Us bacche ne apni class ke ilawa, he have read all the books. He has read all the books of higher classes also. So you can very well imagine how genius he was at that age. So Mr. Coach, without any, you know, showing any disagreement, he gave consent letter, a reference letter to him. And he says, where we were? Yes. If I say I can't teach you anymore, dhyan se sunna beta. If I say I can't teach you anymore, and probably you will soon be able to teach me, what will that be, right? He said, a teacher knows the level of the student always. So teacher says, I'm giving you this reference letter because soon you are going to, supersede me also. You're going to excel in life and you will be teaching me. Means that caliber you have. So teacher praises him. It's only the truth. That's saying too much, sir. Albert kehta hai, bahut zyada, sir. I don't think so, aisa kuch hai. It's only the truth. All right, I'll put it more seriously. It was still a glowing reference, and Mr. Coach made the point that Albert was ready immediately to enter a college or institute for the study of higher mathematics. So teacher mentioned over there that he's a genius boy. He can enter the college now after school directly, higher level of mathematics, right? I'm sorry you are leaving us, although you are wasting your time in my class, he said. Teacher already knew that this boy has all the knowledge. Whatever I'm teaching in the class, he already know all the concepts. So teacher says, you are wasting your time here. This institute is not for you. You are meant for some other place. So Albert was puzzled. What did the teacher mean? He soon found out before he had a chance to ask for an interview with the head teacher. He was summoned to the head's room. That is the turning point. He thought, I will be taking the certificate to head teacher. Before he could enter the head's room, he was summoned. He was called by the head teacher himself. He was having the certificate in his pocket. Yes, one, seedhe hoke baithiye. So Albert was keeping that certificate to give to head teacher, but he was called by head teacher. Why head teacher called him? Well, it saves me the trouble of having to wait an hour or two outside, he thought. Albert soch raha hai that, okay, otherwise I have to wait 2 hours outside to meet head. Directly he's calling me, it's better. Abhi de aunga certificate. He hardly bothered to wonder why he had been sent for. Sent for means to called upon. So, but vaguely supposed he was to be punished again for bad work and laziness. Well, he had finished with punishments. He thought he never bothered why teacher is calling, head teacher is calling me. I'm not going to punish you, head teacher said to Albert's surprise. Your work is terrible. See, what are the words of the head teacher to Albert Einstein, who's a genius, a scientist now? Your work is terrible. I'm not prepared to have you here any longer, Einstein. I want you to leave the school now. That was the expulsion call for Albert Einstein. Clear? He was expelled from the school because he never bothered to follow what teachers were teaching. He never bothered to cram the facts. He was arguing with the teachers sometimes also. So his behavior was not at all acceptable in the institution. So he was called to expelled from that time only. And I'm not going to punish you. He said that, leave school now, repeated Albert. Dazed. He says, leave school now? He was shocked. That is what I said, head repeated. You mean that I am to be expelled. So Albert was shocked that mujhe nikala ja raha, expulsion, nikal dena. You can take it the way you want to. Einstein, head teacher, was not mincing words. Mincing words means he was not beating about the bush. Baat ko bada chada ke nahi bol raha tha. He was just not hiding it. He was directly, he was very clear. He says, simplest thing will be for you to go to your own accord, then the question won't arise. So you can do what you want to. You can leave our school now. But, said Albert, what crime have I committed? He's right. What crime he has committed? Do you find any crime here? Anything which he has done that he should be expelled? But he was expelled. Your presence. Now, the explanation given by the teacher. So these words, you know, matter the most. The kind of words we use for you people. That matters a lot. That gives the permanent. If I say, wow, what a wonder. If I keep on praising you, that is also not good. If I keep on punishing you and snubbing you and using negative remarks, that is also not good. Fine. Teacher should always encourage the student to, you know, your competition is yourself only, not others. Firstly, you should see, where did I stand last time? Where to have I have to go the next time? So we should encourage you all the time that you can do. Yes, you have the caliber. You can improve, and then definitely it gives a kind of boost to your energy levels. If I say, no, you do not have the caliber, you cannot do it, you're not meant for this, it will strike into your mind, and your mind, you know, our brain gives signal to our whole body. If negativity is there, negativity will be channelized. So it's up to you how you take the things. Okay? It's up to you. You have to be positive to make your life positive. So he says, head teacher says, okay, I will tell you why we are expelling you. Your presence in the classroom makes it impossible for the teacher to teach. When you are present in the class, you do not let teachers to teach. And for the other pupils to learn. Other pupils means other students. Pupils means students. The other students are getting affected with your presence. You refuse to learn. You are in constant rebellion. Who's a rebel? R-E-B-E-L. A rebel is a person who does opposite of what is asked to him. If I say stand up, he will sit down. If I say sit down, he will stand up. If I say, okay, tell me the answer, he will argue. So opposite of anything what is asked. So he say, you are a constant rebellion. You are opposing the teacher's notions. Specifically, Mr. Braun here, it means teacher might have talked to the head teacher about the incident. No serious work can be done while you are there. So according to us, when you are present in the class, nothing can be done. Albert felt the medical certificate almost burning a hole in his pocket. You can very well imagine the condition of that boy. He did so many efforts. Doctor se mila, he got that certificate. He was going through a lot of problems in his personal life as well. Then keeping that certificate and getting insulted in front of him, he felt that medical certificate is of no use now. It is kind of burning hole into his pocket. Underline, this is a question in your text. We will discuss this later on. Let's finish the chapter first because you have test. I was going to leave anyway, he said. Now he said, I was going to leave anyway. Then we are in agreement. Head teacher says, okay, we agree to you. If you wanted to leave only, we agree to you, Einstein had said. For a moment, Albert was tempted to tell the man what he thought of him and of his school. You know, us time pe kya hota hai? Adolescents, those at this age, they're full of anger. They sometimes, you know, they can speak anything. So he felt like telling to the head that what is this education system where you are mugging up the information only? No creativity, no imagination, no novelty or newness of the ideas. This is education system. He felt like saying to him, but he stopped himself. You tell me, did he do right thing? Usko bolna chahiye tha ki nahi bolna chahiye? Yes, one says yes. Who says no? Yes, Jodhpreet? Jodhpreet, are you listening? Yes. This girl? 1 minute, sir, I'm winding up. You can go from this side only, beta. Go and meet there. Then we are in agreement, he says. For a moment, Albert was tempted to tell, but he stopped himself without another word. Holding his head high, he stalked out. He walked out. Fine? Holding his head high means he was not at all affected. He was showing that I'm happy. That was a moment that in arrogance kehlo aap or self-belief kehlo. So he walked out, shut the door after you, shouted the head. Albert ignored him. When he walked out, door remained open and head said, leave, close that door. He did not pay attention to it because he was so frustrated. He without, you can say closing the door, he walked out. He walked straight on out of the school where he had spent 5 miserable years. Wait, let me finish. Without turning his head to give it a last look, he could not think of anyone he wanted to say goodbye to. He did not say goodbye to not a single person. He did not look back even. He walked out of the school without giving a single look even. Indeed, Yuri was almost the only person in Munich he felt like seeing before he left the town. He had come to hate almost as much as the school. Elsa was back in Berlin and he had no other real friends. So that place was not at all good for him. His experience, 5 years were miserable. He had only best friend Yuri in the same town. So he only met Yuri before leaving. His cousin was already gone to Berlin. Goodbye and good luck, said Yuri when he left. You are going to a wonderful country, I think. I hope you will be happier there. So that was the end of the chapter and end of the lecture too. You will be having the test today. I will be sharing at 1:00, okay?